Quality service, premium products, and a name you can trust. These are the three fundamental pillars of our company, Garmund Construction Rentals. Good afternoon. My name is Ashley, and I'm here to present to you the best business option that will ensure future sustainability and growth. To start off, we came up with a primary issue and your objectives, or our objectives. And our objective is to become the premium purveyor of high-quality and heavy-duty construction equipment in Fort McMurray, Alberta. Next, this led into our opportunity, which is what is the best avenue for Garmund Construction Rentals to grow its operations and achieve long-term sustainability. This led into some secondary issues as well. We came up with four, which is the oil price, market saturation, organizational structure, and the urgency. So critical insight on the oil price is the oil price drives the economy in Fort McMurray. Everything is based around the oil price. Next secondary issue is the market saturation. And it is established competition in the market right now. The organizational structure, there is a clear role and quality command. And lastly, there is an urgency that needs to be addressed. And there is a small window to capitalize on the current market right now. Next, we looked at the qualitative analysis on the industry, organization, and primary stakeholders. The industry in a volatile economic position, market is driven by the oil price. So to capitalize and to continue growing, everything is driven by the oil price. Next, the consumer confidence is low because the dollar per barrel of oil is lower than previous years, and thus the gross spending is lower. And most of market dominated by a few larger competition. Therefore, right now we don't have too much competition against us. Next, we look at the organization. You have proven success and have focused on high quality and customer service. However, there is a split focus between the East market and the West market right now. The core competencies in Ontario are different compared to the ones in Alberta because it is different provinces. And as well, the business model is derived around the oil price, as which I previously said is prior. And lastly, we looked at the primary stakeholders. So the first one is the Komatsu. The move to Redwood LTD, they would consider moving to them if we didn't go with their option right away. And looking to aggressively grow, and they are assuming the oil decline will not cause a market collapse, which could possibly happen, but they are just assuming that this decline will go away and we will come into a sustainable market. And lastly, we looked at the employees. They are looking for job security while the market is declining. And there is expensive living costs in Fort McMurray right now. And they need to be compensated well to stay and work for you guys. I will pass it off to Kyle, and he will go through the qualitative analysis.
So for our quantitative analysis, we wanted to give you a net present value for the three options of the existing companies currently offered that you could possibly purchase in the future. You'll see here it is for Transverse. We have the initial investment of the $61 million, and that represents 70% of the purchase price based off of the 6x and 7x average of the pre-tax earnings. We've also calculated a 10% drop in revenues in 2016 based off of the estimated 2015 numbers that were provided, and a further 2% decrease per year based off of the current market conditions continuing into the near future. We've also calculated that for the expenses as a decrease of 1% in order to, they are decreasing 1% in order to reflect the 2% decrease in sales, as cost of sales would be decreasing as well, but general and administrative expenses would continue to increase in the over this time period in reflect to inflation, and that is why the 2% and 1% don't run parallel to one another. We've also included the principal repayment on the loan of the $61.4 million and calculated after-tax profit for the next 5 years. We've also included a terminal value using a terminal growth rate of 2%, and this represents the future cash flows, future free cash flows after 2020, based off of the after-tax profit in 2020. And this comes up to an NPV of a negative $31 million for Transverse. We reflected the same assumptions for the other three options as well. So for Caledon, it came up with a negative NPV of $91 million, and for Vanguard of $66 million. We have then calculated what it would be in order for us to open our own stores using the same assumptions. We would request a $50 million loan from Komatsu in order to cover the initial cost of purchasing machinery and setting up the buildings. And this came up with a negative NPV of close to $70 million. Now I'll bring up Zach to talk through our decision criteria.
All right, thanks, Kyle. So as Kyle said, I'm going to take you through just the very basis that we use when evaluating the options before our company today. Now, I know that we've presented a rather bleak looking picture about our alternatives, but it is important to note under our first option of financial viability that we, to stay conservative and to make sure that we're sustainable at $30 per barrel of oil and at $100 per barrel of oil, that we've looked at the worst case scenario for you today. That being said, under financial viability, it's very important that no matter what decision we go with, it's going to leave us in a stronger financial position tomorrow and a year from now and 10 years from now. Leading into that is future sustainability. We want to be able to grow now, capitalize on our market share now, consolidate in Fort McMurray, but also leave ourselves doors open to consolidate the market further, to expand further and grow our company to its full potential. And then lastly, we wanted to look at competitive advantage. Right now, as Ashley alluded to in the qualitative considerations for this, for our company, our business model is driven primarily by the oil sector. That change is substantial right now. We've seen a huge swing, and if we don't adapt, if we can't evolve our competitive advantage and focus it on more than just one area, then we won't be around to have these discussions in the next few years. So we're going to make sure that whatever decision that we put forward to you today, it's going to ensure that we are there in 5 years to make those decisions. That being said, the first decision that we looked at was to exit the market or stay the course. Under exiting the market, we're obviously seeing a lot less risk. There's far less upfront costs, and we do get to focus on the core competencies that Ashley talked about in Eastern Canada. However, we run the risk of losing that number one position in the market and losing that control to Redwood, as Komatsu has made abundantly clear that they will move to the other purveyor if we pass on the opportunity to grow their brand in Alberta. We're also looking at when the market for oil eventually does bounce back and the money starts flowing back into Fort McMurray, the barriers for re-entry to that market could be substantial, more than the cost of any losses that we might run in the next couple of years. We're looking at a damaged relationship with Komatsu as well. Their ambition should align closer to our ambition. They want to grow their brand, we want to grow our brand. And employees that we currently have in Alberta are lacking, they have no job left. There is no more job security. We'd be failing on our promise to the employees. On the flip side, we have stay the course. We capitalize on our market consolidation opportunity. We grow our brand in Alberta right now. We strengthen that relationship with Komatsu, and we diversify our company across different provinces. There is more risk and more upfront costs that we're going to touch on later, and you do run the potential of losses in the first few years, but those considerations taken in, we believe that the only way is forward. We stay the course in Alberta. The second decision that we looked at was to purchase existing companies or to grow our company organically. First, we looked at purchasing Transverse, as it was the best option as presented in our quantitative analysis. You're getting an established company with a customer base that's already there. There's not going to be any of those initial construction costs or delay for construction costs apart from a few minor upgrades and things of the kind. You're looking to consolidate the market from your competitors. You're literally taking competitors away from the market and putting that revenue in your pocket. And you're diversifying your product offerings as Transverse has a wider array of rentals. that you can incorporate into, or we can incorporate into our business model. However, as with the purchase options, this does preclude a premium to be paid on the company as we're in a downturn. The owners of these companies have lived through cyclical oil prices in the past, and they're not in a great position to sell, so we would be looking at a premium. There would be the cost of rebranding them to our company's brand, and then the retention of the employees and training is a question that's in the air. Do we keep the employees on and hope that they can adapt to our business model, or do we bring new employees in and incur the cost on that? And as well, the interest on the debt is, it's important to note, the interest on the debt of the loan repayment to Komatsu based over 10 years is the reason for the negativity in the net present value analysis. And the principal payment, I should say, rather, not the interest. On the other option, to launch more of our own stores, we build up our brand organically from the start. We fully control from day one. We have the hype surrounding a new store coming to the market. There's no premium to acquire that ownership, and there's less debt required for that startup as we can get Komatsu to finance the initial investment. However, you're getting that long construction time. There's no established customer base at all. You're still competing with the same people in the market. You're just adding to the saturation. And then you're having to train and bring in those new employees. So based on these considerations and some slight alterations that we're going to talk about in decision number three, we decided to have you purchase Transverse Rentals. That leads me to decision number three, which is how are we going to pay for it? What are we going to do for financing? On the one hand, we have sole debt financing. On the other hand, we have an equity partnership with Komatsu. Under debt financing, we know most of the details already. They're approved for 70% of the initial investment, and we retain complete control. However, there's a large principal that severely dampens the financial viability of this option. There's Eastern Garamount is going to have to subsidize the losses, and they're going to be heavier losses in those first few years, and the debt-to-equity ratio on the balance sheet is going to skyrocket, more than past an area that we're comfortable having. So we're going to move in ahead with the equity partnership in Komatsu. And what that's going to entail is creating the Alberta division into a joint venture with Komatsu, where we're going to, where they're going to cover 50% of that initial investment for 49% of the company, and we're going to loan back from them the other percent and pay that principal and interest at a higher rate until that is paid down, and then we'll operate as a joint venture in Alberta. What that's going to allow is for Komatsu to give a direct route to the Canadian market. They've expressed how important it is to them to really grow their Canadian brand. This is giving them a direct route. It's strengthening our partnership with them. It's bringing us closer together. And it's going to allow for them to absorb some of those costs, but to get that healthy payout not too far in the future. There will be a loss of partial control, but in an economy like this, in a market the way that we're looking at, a loss of partial control is better than no company at all. We want to grow our brand. We want to capitalize on that market. I'm now going to bring, our recommendation. We have some additional items to consider. We highlighted how important the organizational culture was. We want to make sure that you bring in someone local, trusted, and qualified as an executive position in Alberta so that operations aren't happening half the country away. We also want you to have a monthly meeting with Komatsu to keep them in the loop on any business direction changes. And then further on in our implementation, we're going to talk about adding a marketing campaign in Alberta to drive up sales, drive up consumer confidence. So what have we looked at? We want you to stay the course, purchase Transverse Rentals, turn the Alberta operation into a joint venture with Komatsu, and then bring on a trusted, qualified local executive. Just behind me now, really quickly, I'm going to go through some recommendation financials. You'll see that taking away 50% of that upfront cost, still including the principal payment on the other 50%, our net present value moves from a negative $30 million to a positive $4.4 million. And this, again, I want to stress, is at the worst case scenario. This is if oil prices don't rebound for 10 years. This is if sales continue to decline. So we're looking at a sustainable position. I'm now going to bring Kyle up here, who's going to talk to you about our implementation plan and how we're going to get this up and off the ground.
So for the first thing with our implementation, we wanted to focus on the short term, which was getting us from September to December 2015. First thing that we wanted to do was to propose and obtain the joint ventureship with Komatsu in order to have that capital available for the expansion. So we allocated $100,000 to cover the legal expenses associated with drafting this joint partnership and allowed a 3-month time frame. We then have them purchase transverse rentals in month four for the purchase price indicated on the screen. We would then hire a senior financial management member for Alberta in order to oversee the new joint partnership. We allocated $10,000 in order to cover the costs of finding, hiring, and training this individual, and allowed 2 months for training. In our medium term, so this is for our next year, which would be January to December 2016, we want to set up monthly meetings with Komatsu in order to communicate how the joint partnership is doing and make sure that we're all on the same page. And this would be monthly meetings going forward into the foreseeable future. We'd also attempt to try and retain Transverse's current employees in order to get a sense of continuity and keep the quality employees that they have employed with them right now. And then we also need to get Komatsu's equipment in place in order to ensure the wide variety of options at the stores that we have now purchased and expanded with. And then begin that marketing campaign in order to advertise our rebranded stores and the new products available, and allocate a 2% of the partnership revenue towards this marketing campaign. In our long term, 2017 and forward, we want to start implementing some key performance indicators in order to measure how this partnership is going forward. And we want to start with how the construction market is versus a dollar per barrel of oil, see how they correlate and how we can incorporate that into some sales forecasts. We also want to look at consumer confidence and make sure that the environment and market in Fort McMurray is sustainable for the future, and get some employee engagement back. Now that we've hopefully retained those employees from Transverse, we want to see how they are feeling being incorporated into Garamond. Also want to continue that marketing campaign in order to maintain and grow presence in the market in the foreseeable future. And then eventually by year five, we can evaluate more expansion opportunities. There was two other companies still in Fort McMurray right now that we chose to pass on purchasing. In the future, if oil rebounds and our business has started to take off again, we can further consolidate the Alberta market share. Ashley's now going to go through some risks and mitigations with our proposal.
So like every good business plan, there are some risks that come along with it. So we looked at four, which are measured on an impact and probability scale. The first one is Komatsu says no to joint venture. To mitigate this, we would offer guaranteed royalty till principal is repaid to Komatsu. And also we could there could be possible revenue guarantees as well. Next, we looked at Transverse doesn't sell. And to mitigate it, we would evaluate option for joint venture with new shares, offer more shares, with new stores. Sorry about that. And then the next risk we looked at was backlash from Transverse employees. And to mitigate it, we would communicate higher wages and job security. So this would be if they backlash to the sale to us. And so to mitigate it, like I had said, we would offer the higher wages. And lastly, we looked at the risk that was the lowest impact and lowest probability. And Traverse's employees are not as qualified as we would like them to be. So to mitigate it, we would provide additional training and to bring them up to speed with our core competencies. I'm going to pass it off to Zach to wrap us up today.
All right, so what have we looked at for you here today? We evaluated an opportunity for our company, and that would be to what is the best avenue for us to expand in a healthy and sustainable way. We want us to stay the course in Alberta, purchase that Traverse competitor, start a joint venture with Komatsu, and improve our organizational structure. What this is going to allow is for us to continue to be the premium purveyor of high-quality, reliable construction equipment. The only way to go is forward. We know that our plan is aggressive, but we feel that we can get this done, we can grow our company, we can be the premium option in the future. I'd like to thank you very much for your time and open the floor to any questions.
Thank you. That concludes the presentation portion. The question and answer period will now begin. How do you feel your Komatsu product line, or our Komatsu product line, will fit with Traverse's product line?
That's an excellent question. So right now, Traverse isn't as deep into the heavy equipment sales. So we're hoping that we can leverage that new added piece of the market in, and it with little friction. Their small tool sales is something that we haven't been into before. So as long as that is okay with our Komatsu joint venture, we can operate those two simultaneously with as minimal friction as possible.
With that, I guess, so there's a few things. I'll go back to that one. My first question is, so you talked about putting executive in Alberta, which is a good plan. You're going to help to increase the way the stores are run there. You also looked at training costs, higher wages and stuff. Are all of those built into your net PV that you calculated for us? Have you included all those additional costs, I guess, that we're going to be incurring to make sure that this is successful?
Those additional costs for the hiring and training have not been included with the net present value right now. But going forward, if we get a better estimate of the cost and how much this is going to impact the company, we can reflect those into the net present value and come back to you at a later date with those revised financials.
Just to build on that, our net present value is based on incremental additions, right? And so part of the organizational structure changes we felt were integral no matter which company we decided to purchase. And so with every NPV, those costs that Kyle mentioned, when we get a better picture of them, are going to be built in the same fashion.
Perfect. And then I think just to follow up on the question, so switching, I guess, number one, are you concerned about losing customers that we're going to be purchasing because now we're going to be selling a Komatsu brand? Companies are very brand loyal, and so we might lose some of that. And also, I guess, just what are we going to get for those equipment sales from those brands that they're carrying, their Caterpillar, and I'm not sure what the other one is, but...
So their current brands, we're going to try to liquidate, obviously, as soon as possible. The Komatsu brand is already number two in Canada. We're going to implement our marketing campaign as well, and we're going to push the higher quality, the higher customer service level. People are generally very committed to the brands they know, but that doesn't mean that for a better service experience or for a better dollar even, that they wouldn't be willing to entertain the possibility of something else. So we're confident that we're not going to lose a lot of sales. Plus, we already have a very dedicated customer base that we're just expanding their opportunities for.
Clarify and expand on the worst case financial scenario. I think I saw that it was still a positive cash flow. And I guess the second part of that is, you know, did you think about the implication on the rest of the company if that is in fact not the worst case scenario?
With those financials, some of the cash flows do remain positive, but is that large initial investment in order to cover the purchase of Transverse that makes the NPV a negative NPV? And sir, can you repeat the second part of the question?
Well, I just wondered if it wasn't, so for instance, if oil stayed low for 6, 8, 10 years, I just wonder about the consideration and impact having gone down an M&A strategy on the rest of the organization.
Well, we have calculated the terminal value in order to take into account some of those free cash flows into the future, order that 6 to 10 year range if this was the worst case scenario. So if oil was not to rebound in the dollar per barrel right now, that has been reflected in the terminal value with our NPV calculation. Thanks.
I just have a quick question, I guess, as the owner of Garamond. It does concern me that we'd be pursuing an equity partnership with my manufacturer and allowing them to now move into the thing that I do, and what's to prevent them from making my sales contacts and eventually eliminating me as that middle person?
So we've offered the 49-51%, so that would give us still the 51% ownership of the company. We are in the like recessionary or in an economic downturn. Therefore, we thought, like, other than taking the debt financing, this would be your best option to go forward with.